No matter how disciplined you might be about your sleep schedule or fitting in those morning workouts, there's no denying the fact you've maintained a few bad eating habits throughout your weight loss journey. But willpower isn't always to blame. It's also your brain's fault. You see, when you've trained your brain to do something, it ultimately becomes second nature. As a result, your noggin essentially shuts off when you undertake a habit, whether it's brushing your teeth before bed or reaching for that midday soda, and it doesn't exert the same control it would over more important, new things. One of those important, new things that it does seem to fight back against? A completely refurbished diet. And that's one of the reasons why dropping those pounds is so difficult. Most weight loss routines begin by changing your diet. But many of those diet changes often take too much willpower to sustain in the long term. So while you might lose weight initially, it can just as easily come right back. Hi, my name is Mary, and welcome to your Health Academy. If this is the first time you are visiting our channel, make hit the subscribe button, and turn on the notifications to learn more about the facets of physical and mental health, beauty, diets and weight loss, meditation, and much more. So we're here to help you stay on track and break all of those unhealthy eating habits. Here are some of the most effective, science-backed strategies for how you can control your environment so you can break those waistline-destroying habits and start snacking smarter once and for all. 1. Clean your kitchen. A study published in the journal Environment and Behavior found just being in a cluttered, messy kitchen can cause us to eat more. How much more? According to the study, 40%. Researchers gave snacks to 100 women, half of which were in a clean kitchen, and half of which were in a messy kitchen, strewn with mail, newspapers, and dirty dishes. Those in the messy kitchen consumed nearly twice as many calories from cookies as women in the tidy kitchen. And a separate, similar study done in an office, found that people in the orderly room were more inclined to choose a healthy snack like an apple. Take this tip. Whether it's your kitchen, a workplace desk, or even your bedroom, make sure you're keeping the places in your life neat and tidy to keep yourself from unnecessarily snacking. 2. Hide your vices. The foods that are easiest to reach for are the ones you're most likely to take. A study conducted at Google's New York office found that placing M&Ms in opaque containers as opposed to glass ones and giving healthier snacks more prominent shelf space curbed candy consumption by 3.1 million calories in just 7 weeks. So what does that mean for your weight? Well, a study by Eat This, Not That magazine advisor Brian Wansink, director of the Cornell Food and Brand Lab, might have the answer. After analyzing photos of 200 kitchens, he found that women who have soda sitting on their countertops weigh an average of 26 pounds more, cereal an additional 20 pounds, and cookies about 8 pounds more. The lesson here is clear: clear junk food off your countertops to start losing weight and to make better choices. Take this tip. We know snacking is important to maintain a revving metabolism, but that doesn't mean once in a while treats should constantly be sitting on your desk. Keep any foods that might sabotage your goals out of sight. 3. Prioritize your produce. Simply reorganizing the most accessible foods in your pantry or which sit on your counter could translate into serious calorie savings. So after you remove the junk, replace it with a fruit bowl. You're 70% more likely to grab fruits and veggies over less healthy options if they're readily available or right in front of you, according to more of Wansink's research. Take this tip, place bowls of fruits out on the counter and swap those cookie containers with trail mix, popcorn, or any of these healthy snacks. You can even keep washed and prepared veggies like carrots, cucumbers, peppers, and snap peas with a tub of hummus in the front of the fridge so they aren't overlooked. 4. Turn off the TV. Who knew, you don't just eat with your eyes, researchers say you also eat with your ears. A new study, published in the journal Food Quality and Preference, tested how our perception of the sound of eating food affects our eating habits. They had two groups of participants eat crunchy foods, one with white noise-producing headphones and the other without. These headphones were intended to mimic everyday behaviors of distracted eating, such as watching TV or listening to music while you eat. Participants who were distracted by white noise were less aware of the sound of the food, causing them to eat more than those who could hear the food they were eating. Take this tip. Turn off the TV, or Netflix, for all you cord cutters out there, and lower the music during dinner. And if you're out to dinner at a busy restaurant, maybe think about ordering something crunchy. As long as you can hear the food you are eating, it'll make you aware of the fact that you're eating food. When you're unaware, you forget that you're eating, which can lead to an increase in food consumption. 5. Change your plate size. Oh, but you eat with your eyes, too. When you serve yourself on a bigger plate, food appears smaller, which can lead to over-searching and overeating. Contrarily, smaller plates make food servings appear significantly larger, tricking your mind into thinking you're about to consume more calories than you are. In one study, campers who were given larger bowls served themselves and consumed 16% more cereal than those given smaller bowls. Plus, starting small makes it less likely you will go for seconds, and forces you to check in once the plate is cleared before filling up again, says Lisa Hyam, Road. Take this tip. Swapping dinner plates for salad plates will help you eat more reasonable portions, which can help the pounds fly off your frame. Munching's research showed that simply using a smaller plate could cut down on food served by 22%. 6. Switch to a smaller glass. Those sparkling crystal glasses look mighty fine, but they might be influencing you to drink more than you should, which means you'll end up consuming more nutrient-deficient calories. Another study by Munching found that people automatically pour more liquid into short, wide glasses than in tall, skinny ones of the same volume. Take this tip. Just like you'll hope to do with your body, swap your fat glasses out for leaner glasses and you could cut alcohol or sugary drink consumption by 10%, which will certainly do great things for your waistline and health. 7. Use snack bags. Changing your environment also means changing the portion sizes of the foods you tend to reach for. Munching mindlessly straight out of a bag or box while you're standing at the pantry deciding what you want to eat leads to overeating, advise the nutrition twins, Lissy Lakatos, RDN, CDN, CFT and Tammy Lakatos Shames, RDN, CDN, CFT. Planning what you're going to eat and sitting down to a predetermined portion on a plate eliminates this problem. It's even scientifically proven. In an experiment at the Cornell University Food and Brand Lab, researchers gave study participants either a single bag containing 100 wheat thins or four smaller bags holding 25 each, waited for the munching to subside, then did a cracker count. The tally, those given the jumbo bag consumed about 20% more. Take this tip, individually portion out the foods you tend to overeat, and even the ones you don't, to the recommended serving size. You can even write a reminder of how many calories are in each by using a Sharpie to write directly on the bag. 8. Unfollow. In this day and age, your phone is as much a part of your environment as it's also an extension of your hand. And that's not great news when you want to start eating healthier. As it turns out, scrolling through your social feeds is just as bad for your gut as seeking out those trending treats themselves. A review published in the journal Brain and Cognition found that when we see food porn, it exacerbates our desire for food through a channel of neural and physical responses called visual hunger. In other words, even if we're not physically in need of food, our bodies will send a signal to our brains, via the hunger hormone ghrelin, that we want to eat. Take this tip, if you don't want to end up eating the same high-energy, belly-busting foods you see in your Insta feed, unfollow. And start following accounts that highlight better for you choices. A study in experimental brain research found that our brains don't become as an alert in response to seeing photos of low-energy, healthy foods like veggies, so you won't be encouraged to eat when you aren't hungry. 9. Have a meal plan. Variety might be the spice of life, but it's a habit breaker. Plus, planning out what you're going to make every night, the day of, can be a pain. Because we make approximately 200 food choices each day, we get fatigued towards the end of the day, comments Juliana Hever, MS, Road, CPT. Meal planning is optimal to help you gain control of your overall food intake. That's right, it's not bad news if you've fallen into the habit of buying, making, and eating the same foods every week. According to a survey of millions of Britons, 60% of adults eat the same dishes every week, and 1 in 4 adults even cooks the same meal on the same day. The reason? About 1 in 5 people claim that if they haven't planned anything, they are more inclined to fall back on a frozen pizza, chips, or takeout. And experts agree. Take this tip, have a few go-to meals you eat consistently. That way, you can conserve your willpower for more important decisions. You can even sort meals onto specific days. Taco Tuesday, anyone? Just make sure you're packing plenty of colorful veggies into your meal plan, as eating the rainbow assures you're getting an array of micronutrients. 10. Adopt eating rituals. Bad eating habits exert an impressionable influence on people who live in a non-patterned environment. And sometimes, we have no choice. When your job requires you to fly to another state every couple of weeks or your kids' sports schedules are always up in the air, it can be hard to keep a consistent, daily schedule. That's why experts believe it's important to establish eating rituals. Research suggests these rituals are a form of mindful eating, which have the power to make food more pleasurable and may help prevent overeating. In one study, participants who were assigned to eat a chocolate bar by a particular breaking and unwrapping ritual found the candy much more enjoyable, and even more flavorful, than a group who ate the bar informally. Take this tip, when you can, make an effort to sit at the table with your family during meals. Or, always step away from your desk during lunch and sit in the park. Removing yourself from work and other distractions and putting yourself in an environment that always means, it's time to eat, will allow you to more mindfully focus on eating. That way, you won't be irrationally snacking while you're on the couch or blindly chowing down as you finish a project. So, we have finished this video. Thank you for watching, I hope you found this video informative and actionable. If you got some value out of it, don't forget to hit that like button, and then subscribe for more videos. See you in the next video, bye!